we the people. The traditional definition of secularism used to be separation between the church and the state. In India, not just has that definition never worked, but godmen of all religious denominations, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, have often been directly or indirectly involved in politics. Most recently was the famous case of Baba Ramdev, one of the most popular spiritual leaders in this country, saying that we should vote for the party that has made getting back money stashed away in Swiss banks back to India. That's the party that deserves our vote. That party, of course, happens to be the BJP. Sri Sri Ravi Shankar also believed that this was a good and legitimate issue. In Kerala, we have seen sections of the church actually saying vote for anybody but the communists who are atheist. And in Delhi, we have the Shahi Imam, among others, who is actually asking Muslims to consolidate and backing specific candidates. But is this an unholy alliance? Should holy men stay away from politics? Let me start with Siddharth Singh of the BJP. Siddharth, of course, Advani ji wrote a letter to many spiritual leaders, not of any one religion, different religions, really pointing to the fact that if the BJP government is, if the BJP is voted back to government, spiritual leaders will be involved in political decision making. Is this a healthy trend?
It's not political decision making. He has said that they will be involved in bringing, you know, for example, there are pilgrim sites are there. They've been neglected for a long time. There are security concerns. You have seen many mishaps happening in the security, you know, when you go for a pilgrim, there are so many who have died. So all those things he's brought. And his letter is addressing to the religious, irrespective of faith, asking them to look at what is the state of affairs of this country today. He's spoken about unemployment. He's spoken about terrorism. He's spoken about, you know, many other things. Like,
but you don't think this will create an overlap
why should we look at from there? In fact, Mahatma Gandhi himself has said that India, if you separate religion and politics, is a sin. He goes to that extent and say it's a sin. So you cannot segregate, because again, the religious leaders, irrespective of faith, they do have an influence on the society. In building up a good society, that's what the religion is all about.
So according to you,
build a good society, and to bring justice to that society is a political way.
So that's the way they go about. Mahesh Bhatt, although you're not a politician, you are in this election, if I'm right, actually trying to consolidate the Muslim vote in UP, and you're telling Muslims to vote for the Congress.
The Millat Bedari Mohim Committee is an NGO consisting of very bright students and faculty members of the Aligarh Muslim University. They pride themselves on being modern. They have a scientific temper. They want to not wear the religious hat. They're concerned about the landscape of UP because there are many spoilers there. And they feel that since we are talking about a government at the center, we need to choose a government which can possibly deliver what they think is a secular government.
But when you try and consolidate a vote along religious lines, isn't that in a way stereotyping or upholding that great one myth of India, that there is such a thing called the Muslim vote?
Well, you would be a damn fool to believe that there isn't something like the Muslim.
Well, I mean, I just mean the
statistics show that everybody is trying to kind of galvanize the support of that particular vote.
Okay, Swami Agnivesh, you know, you look like the prototype Swami, but you often have very different positions from, let's say, the position Baba Ramdev, whom we'll be speaking to in just a few minutes, have taken. Do you agree with Siddharth that even Mahatma Gandhi said you can't separate religion and politics, and in fact that brand of secularism has never worked in India?
First of all, Barkha, let me tell you that I do not agree when you make religious leaders and spiritual leaders coterminous.
Okay.
Spirituality is something universal and which has a subversive element in it. Religion is status quoist. Organized religions are very much based on some dogma, some belief system, some superstition.
Okay, fair enough. But I'm saying anything. Okay.
Now, these religious leaders, organized religious leaders, should have no business meddling in politics.
Because
this type of religion is always divisive, it always is obscurantist, it's never based on secular agenda.